6 months after Bangladesh was born, on the 2nd of July 1972, Indira Gandhi and Pakistan's Zulfikar Ali Bhutto signed the Simla Agreement, an event that became a milestone in India's modern history. Under the agreement, India agreed to release 93,000 Pakistani soldiers taken as prisoners of war after taking the consent of Bangladesh leader Sheikh Mujibur Rahman. It also agreed to return the 5,000 square miles of Pakistan's territory it had captured during the war. While this closed the chapter on the Bangladesh War, the Simla Agreement is significant for two other decisions that were taken. First, the two countries agreed to convert the UN-sponsored ceasefire line of 1948 into a line of control, or LOC. They said they would uphold the inviolability of the LOC in the interest of durable peace. Second, India and Pakistan resolved to settle all disputes through bilateral talks and other means, ruling out third-party mediation. The Simla Agreement thus buried Pakistan's insistence on finding a solution to the Kashmir problem through UN mediation or by involving global powers. The Kashmir issue had been discussed by the UN Security Council for the first time on the 1st of January 1948 at India's request after Pakistan sent tribal raiders to capture Kashmir. On the 5th of January 1949, the Security Council passed a resolution urging India and Pakistan to create a mechanism to hold a free and impartial plebiscite in Kashmir. Pakistan was called upon to withdraw from the areas it had occupied in 1947 as a condition of holding the plebiscite. That never happened. Ever since, India had struggled to stop world leaders from meddling in Kashmir's affairs. The Simla Agreement, inked by Indira Gandhi on behalf of India, drew flak from a section of political leaders and strategic experts. Immediately, questions were asked about why India had squandered an opportunity to leverage India's position of strength after the victory in negotiations with Pakistan. Why didn't Indira compel Pakistan to sign an agreement for permanent settlement of the vexed Kashmir dispute? Why did she accept Bhutto's verbal assurance to recognize the LOC as a mutually agreed upon boundary at a later date? After all, Indira had a bargaining chip of 93,000 Pakistani soldiers and vast territory in India's possession. According to journalist Inder Malhotra, Indira's top most concern after the war ended was a safe return of Sheikh Mujibur Rahman, who had been sentenced to death in a hasty trial by Pakistan. In an interview to the New York Times, dated 17th January 1972, Mujib had said that the order for his execution had been given in the final hours of the India-Pakistan war by Pakistani President Yahya Khan. However, Bhutto saved him as he realized the uproar it would create, and Mujib returned to Bangladesh on the 10th of January 1972. Indira's other concern was recognition of Bangladesh by Pakistan and other countries. Writing about the Simla summit, Catherine Frank, Indira Gandhi's biographer, says that all through the five-day Indo-Pak talks in Simla, there was a visible discomfort between Indira and Bhutto. The discussions were held in a tense atmosphere, with India insisting on a final solution to the Kashmir problem and Pakistan focused on securing the release of its prisoners of war and lost territory. The talks reached a deadlock on the last day, that is the 2nd of July, with no sign of an agreement. But that night, as the closing banquet was about to begin at the governor's residence, Bhutto suggested a one-on-one meeting with Indira. Taking up the Kashmir problem, Indira said that converting the UN-sponsored 1948 ceasefire line into an international boundary in Kashmir would be a win-win situation for both countries. While Bhutto felt that this would weaken his position in Pakistan, he agreed with the idea of recognizing the LOC as the international boundary and promised to implement it later. But he said he simply couldn't put it in writing. The agreement was in line with P.N. Haksar's thinking, as Indira's key strategist, Huxer believed that the Simla summit should not be viewed as a negotiation between victor and vanquished. He pointed to the Treaty of Versailles after the First World War, where Allied powers had forced their will on a defeated Germany, and this had led to the rise of Hitler and Nazism. Indira and Bhutto signed the Simla Agreement at 12:40 a.m. But Bhutto went back on his word to recognize the LOC. After assuming power as Prime Minister in 1973, he talked about starting a thousand-year war against India over Kashmir. Indira had learned from the Treaty of Versailles and did not impose humiliating terms of peace on a defeated nation. But Bhutto and Pakistan had discarded the hard lessons of Bangladesh. On Kashmir, Pakistan has honored the Simla Agreement more in breach than in observance, and argues that a bilateral agreement cannot supersede a UN resolution.